Hi everyone, my name is Mahesh. I am going to start a series on Java. I'll be teaching from basic to advanced and I'll try to cover each concept in detail. So let's get started with Java introduction. So what Java is? We all know Java is a programming language, right? So let us understand what the term programming language is. So a language is a medium of communication. Now we wanted to communicate with a machine, with a computer system. So how do we do that? For that, we use a language called programming language. And a program is a set of instructions that we give it to a computer to achieve a particular task. Hence the name, and to write this program, right? So we need a language, hence the name programming language. So C, C++, Java, Python, C sharp are some of the examples of programming languages. Now let us understand features of programming languages. So these are the features of programming languages. It starts with language syntax. So any programming language has its own syntax. So it has like variables and data types. Variables is to store data, and data types, we have like different data types to store different types of data, and conditional statements to check the condition and execute the block of code, and loops, we use it to execute the block of code repetitively. And next is OOP concept. So what is OOP? Object oriented programming concept. So we have classes, objects, we have abstraction, inheritance, polymorphism, encapsulation. All these concepts comes under object oriented programming, usually called as OOP. And all languages except C supports OOP concepts. So all these languages supports OOPs. So only C doesn't support OOP concepts. Next comes exception handling. So we write a program, and there can be some unexpected issue or errors might occur, right? So how to handle it? So exception handling mainly talks about it. So to handle the runtime exceptions, so we actually have exception handling. And next is multi-threading. So we have a task and we wanted to divide that task into subtasks and run all the subtasks in parallel or simultaneously at the same time. So that is what we call it as multi-threading. Next comes collections. So collections are the data structures, inbuilt data structures like arrays, array lists, you know, hash map, hash sets, all these comes under collections. Next comes streams. Streams are like we wanted to read an input and we wanted to write an output to some output device. All these comes under streams. So anything related to input output, we usually call it as IO, IO operations. All that comes under streams. And the last thing is API. API is application programming interface. And we have like a set of libraries under it. So each language has its own libraries. Again, like libraries have packages, and each package have like multiple classes, and each class has its own like pre-built functionality in it. So what all we need to know for the API is, so you need to know which class to use and when to use it, like for what functionality you wanted to use it for. So each language has its own set of libraries. So these are the common features of any programming language, right? So whenever you wanted to learn any programming language, right? So you need to learn these concepts. All these, if you learn all these concepts for one language, right? So then our job becomes easy. So from there, learning any new programming language becomes simple, as you just need to concentrate only on the language syntax. Only language syntax changes for any other new programming language you wanted to learn. All these concepts remain same. So only language syntax changes, and what all you need to do to learn a new programming language is just you need to know the syntax of that particular language and practice it for a few days. Can do it. So this is about the features of programming languages. Now let us understand Java buzzwords. Java buzzwords. So first, simple. So if you already know C++ language, so it becomes easy for you to learn Java. as it follows the same syntax, almost same syntax, and the look and feel also will be very similar. And even if you don't know the C++ language, it's also fine. So you don't need like extensive programming training for that. You can easily learn Java. That's why it's called as simple. Next, object oriented. So in real world, everything is considered as an object, and object is a combination of fields, its attributes and methods. And classes and objects are the two main aspects of object oriented concepts. And Java, in Java, so you can't write a single program without creating a class. That's why Java is called as pure object oriented programming language. Distributed. So what are distributed systems? So when we write an application, this application might can contain more than one module, and each module can be on different platforms. Say for example, I have like maybe module 1, which is on Windows. I have module 2, which can be on Linux. And maybe I have another module, which is on Mac. This entire system, we call it as distributed systems. And Java was designed to work with distributed systems. So next is multi-threaded. So a small task or a task is divided into subtasks and are run in parallel. So at the same time, so that we save time and achieving efficiency. And Java supports like multi-threading. Next is robust. So robust is, meaning of robust is like strong, right? So Java has an extensive compile time checking as well as runtime checking as well. So which makes it the choice for creating the highly reliable software. Next is dynamic. So classes are loaded or linked. So classes are linked at runtime and as needed. So that's why it is called as dynamic. Next comes architectural neutral. So this is very important. So I write a Java program and compile it. So we get a bytecode. A bytecode is generated, and this bytecode can be actually executed on any other type of hardware architecture or software architecture without making any changes. That's why it is called as architectural neutral. So say for example, I have written a Java program on Windows. So I compile it, I get a bytecode. So this bytecode can be executed on any other operating system like Linux or Mac without making any changes. So you might have heard this, like people saying Java is platform independent. So this is the main reason behind it. So portable. So I write a Java program and without making any changes can run it on any other platforms. So that's why it is called as ORA. So what does ORA means is write once, run anywhere. So you write your program once and you can run it on any other platforms. So that's why it's portable. Next comes high performance. So in any application, right? So when we develop any application, performance is considered as an important factor, right? So Java achieves superior performance in two ways. So first thing, it has automatic garbage collector, so which runs as a background thread, so and which makes sure that like the memory is available whenever it is required, so leading to better performance. And second thing is, whenever like we are creating some applications which needs like large amounts of computing power, so this computing, which the sections which require intensive computing power, can be, you know, separated and can be rewritten in some native machine code and later can be interfaced with Java platform. So again, leading to better performance. So that's the reason like we can achieve high performance with Java. Next is secure. So Java was designed to work with distributed environments, giving utmost importance to security. So applications developed in Java are secure from intrusion, meaning like applications can't be invaded from outside. So these are the Java buzzwords. So in this video, we started with what a programming language is. We discussed about what are the common features of any programming language. And finally, we covered what are all the Java buzzwords. So that's all for this video. Thanks for watching.